garden land ecosystem. The next one, here we are having another seven types of farming system in which are opted for garden land. So in garden land, as I have said in the earlier ecosystem, that is wetland ecosystem, their crop is same. Most of the crops will have, most of the times we go for only rice, not most of the times, always we go for rice crop. But when it comes to the garden land ecosystem, crops are different. So for example, let us take maize, sorghum, or bajra, or any other millets, or pulse crops, or oil seeds, or any other fodder crops, whatever it may be the crop. Most of the crops can come very well under garden land ecosystem. Garden land ecosystem means sufficient irrigation is available in that particular location to raise all types of crops. So here, based on the component, we have to choose the crop. So I'll be explaining one after the other what component can be done in garden land ecosystem and how they depend on one on another. So in for the crop, for example, let us take crop, maybe some rice, instead of rice we can have maize or some pulse crop, some one cereal crop or pulse crop. And along with the crop, what we are raising here, dairy. Dairy means nothing but cattle, maybe cows or buffaloes or whatever it may be. Along with the crop, we are going for dairy, and along with the dairy, biogas. Hope you all know the meaning of biogas. Biogas means nothing but production of methane gas by using cow dung in anaerobic condition. So when we go for biogas, we can produce methane by which we can go for cooking purpose for the particular family of that farmer. So here, whatever the crop I am raising, that crop stubbles, for example, I am raising maize crop. So that maize crop, immediately after harvest, that same cum that can be fed to the cattle. That cattle can be feed on that, and that cow dung, whatever you are getting, that cow dung can be inserted into the biogas, and from the biogas we'll be getting methane. And the leftover, after we get the gas from the biogas plant, we call that unit called biogas plant. In that plant, this is inlet, just for understanding cause I am telling, and this may be outlet. So after we give the cow dung into the biogas plant, and we'll be maintaining the anaerobic condition, everything will be closed. After some days, what will happen? Methane gas will start emitting out, and this emitted methane gas will be come out from the one pipeline. This can be converted into the farmer's house, and they can use for the cooking purpose, that gas whatever emitted out from the biogas plant. After the methane gas which is emitted out from the biogas unit, the leftover material, the solid material in the biogas plant, we called bio slurry. That leftover material, that slurry can be taken out from the other end, and the same slurry can be applied to the crop, that will become manure to the crop. So biogas also will help, is helping to the farmer's family for the cooking purpose by giving methane as a gas, and the same biogas unit is giving slurry in the form of manure to the crop, as a manure in the form of slurry to the crop. So by depending one another, they are helping the farmer in the garden land ecosystem. Then we let us move into the next model, crop plus dairy plus biogas plus sericulture. So here another component or enterprise we are adding into the garden land ecosystem. So when we look at here, sericulture means rearing of silkworm. Silkworm means, so we all know that for what purpose we raise silkworm, for the to get silk. So for this we want mulberry plant to feed the silkworm. Silkworm, one of the larva. So to feed the silkworm, they feed on mulberry plant leaves. Mulberry plant leaves. So in the crops at a land area, we can leave aside for the mulberry plant, and when we raise the mulberry plant, that same mulberry plant leaves can be fed to the silkworm. And not only that, in the other way, whatever we are raising, the leftover stubbles can be kept aside. And see, another thing we have to remember here, some area we have to leave for the fodder purpose to feed the cattle. Whatever the crop we are raising, the out of which whatever the crop stubble we are getting, that won't be sufficient to feed the dairy cattle. So for which we have to raise separately some amount of land area. We have to keep aside for the fodder purpose to feed the cattle throughout the year. So for the mulberry we'll be raising and one crop and some area for the dairy purpose. So biogas, sericulture. So these all are depending one on another. Sericulture completely depending on the mulberry plant and out of which we'll be getting some silk. But what these larvae, after they feed on the mulberry plant leaves, they'll be giving some excretion, the dropping, whatever the excretion they are giving, that same excretion can be dumped into the field as a manure for the crop. That is one of the advantage to the crop. So larvae also will give excretion because they feed effectively on the mulberry leaf and they'll be giving so much excretion. That excretion, instead of throwing out, that excretion can be used as a manure to the crop. Then next one is crop, dairy, biogas and fishery. Instead of sericulture, they have removed this component and added fishery component into the garden land ecosystem. So already I explained the meaning, the uses of crop, dairy and biogas and fishery. So in wetland system, in the field itself, we digged a pit and there we are rearing fishes. But here we are not going to do the same thing, but instead of that, in the field itself, separately we'll have the pond for the fishes. So whatever the land area that we opted for to raise the fishes, accordingly we have to choose number of fingerlings, that means how many number of fishes can be released into the field to raise the crop. That is about the fishery. So here in biogas, the slurry can be given into the crop and from the dairy also given into the for the fishery. What we have to do is, from dairy we cannot get, but from crop itself, the food material, whatever is there, that can, the harvested thing can be fed to the fishery. And from biogas, slurry also can be given, but that won't be much effective to the fishery. So this is all about the fishery. Then the next one is crop, dairy, biogas. By removing fishery, we add another two, homestead garden plus silviculture. So homestead garden means by raising some vegetables in the field itself. So in the crop area, some amount of crop will be there, some land area, and also some land area crop, some land area, and some land area for the fodder, and some land area for the vegetables to reach the farmer's need. So that is about the homestead garden. Apart from that, we are involving another component called silviculture. Silviculture means nothing but the growing of trees in the agricultural field. So in agriculture field, all around the field, for example, this is the field, all around the field as like borders, we can raise the crop in the field as a border, and there we can get some income. So not only that, to feed the cattle, what the crops, the trees which are raising, the tree leaf can be fed to the cattle. That is also another advantage. And also the crops, some crops will be there where they can come well under the shade. So these trees will cause the shade and they'll help the crop indirectly. And also homestead garden, so some of the leafy vegetables, they come well under the shade. Those crops can be raised under the trees. So this is all about the fourth model. Then let us move into the next model. The same components: crop, dairy, biogas, homestead garden, silviculture plus apiculture. Apiculture means honeybees rearing. Why we need to go for honeybee rearing? So for every crop, what every crop required is pollination. So when we raise more number of honeybees, then ultimately our crop production will be improved by involvement of bees in the field in effectively, and they'll involve in pollination, and ultimately we'll be getting high yield from the crop. And also for which we nothing to do, just they'll go and take the juice from the flowers of the crop and they will feed by themselves. So nothing to be provided to the apiculture, but from apiculture, that means from honeybees, we can get Comb. Comb means the way the honeybee extract from the house of the honeybee, we call comb. That from the comb we can get honey. So they are giving honey to the farmer. Then the next one is crop, dairy, biogas. Instead of going for homestead garden and silviculture, apiculture, we can go for spawn production plus mushroom. I'll explain the meaning of spawn production. But here one thing we have to remember, when we go for spawn production, we have to raise the crop, mostly go for sorghum crop or maize crop, C4 plant. So spawn production means when we want to raise the mushroom, in mushroom we need seeding material. Mushroom is nothing but the fungus, the multiplication of fungi we call mushroom. That is for edible purpose, that means for the human consumption we grow. Different types of mushrooms are there: oyster mushroom, button mushroom, shiitake mushroom, padistra mushroom, like that. We are having different types of mushrooms. So spawn production means the seeding material, that means the fungus that we store for the future purpose. So spawn production, by having sorghum seeds, we'll boil the sorghum seeds, and into those seeds we add this fungus into that seed, so that fungus will feed on those sorghum seeds and they will viable means they live, those cells will live for some time until we start mushroom production. So it is not something like for our crop how we go for seeds, like that spawn production is nothing but the seeding material for to raise the mushroom. So followed by mushroom, by depending on the spawn production we can go for mushroom cultivation in our field itself. Already I said to raise the mushroom we need to maintain separately another shed. Then the last one is crop, dairy, biogas, spawn production, mushroom plus silviculture. Already I said the meaning of silviculture. So when we go for another component, here how many components are coming? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 components we are inserting into the garden land ecosystem. So when we have 6 components in one ecosystem, though one component fails, for example biogas fails, nothing will happen. Other crop can help the farmer, dairy can help the farmer, spawn production, mushroom. See, when we go for spawn production, don't think it won't give any income, but spawn production will also help to put the market forth. That means we can sell the spawn production to other farmers also by producing it in large way. So for our mushroom production, spawn production will be useful as a seeding material, and also the farmers, those who don't produce the spawn, to them also we can sell the spawn production by producing in large quantity. That also another advantage out of spawn production. And also from mushroom we are getting mushroom and we are selling into the market. Not only that, and also after we harvest the mushroom, the leftover thing can be dumped into the field for the manure. Though these are some examples for the garden land ecosystem. Now let us see the interaction between one another. Already I said the advantages, how they depend on another, but what are the disadvantages? As like the earlier ecosystem in wetland, here also more or less all are same, but here sericulture means raising of silkworm, where we have to go season wise. Every season we have to keep the worms, and also we have to raise the mulberry crop. But mulberry plant, once if we establish, it is something like perennial type, where we can go for cuttings and we can raise again and again, and this initial cost is needed little. And also the next one is fishery. In the beginning you have to buy fishes, but not only that, for the biogas you have to go for buying the biogas plant. So this may be little expensive that we have to look into, but initial cost, not all the time, only in the beginning when we want to establish the system, we have to expend on that. Then the next one is homestead garden. Here only land area is required and only seeds are required to raise the vegetables. Then apiculture is there. Here for the apiculture we have to keep the beehive, we called beehive. Beehive means nothing but the honeybees, where we rear them, that particular house we call beehive. For that we have to spend some money. That also initial cost. Once if we settle that, forever it will be remain in the field, that we can manage. So initial capital cost. Then spawn production, mushroom and all already have seen. So silviculture, that means the raising of the tree species. That also in the beginning, once if you plant the trees, they will be perennial and they will be last forever in the field. So from these two ecosystem, that means wetland ecosystem and garden land ecosystem, What we learnt is in the initial itself the cost is very high, that not very high based on the component the cost will be varied. So in the beginning you have to spend some money. Once if you establish the farming system, then from the followed by year or followed by season, farmer doesn't require to spend that much amount to raise the ecosystem. So these are the seven ecosystems which are suitable for the garden land ecosystem. This is all about.